There comes a time in every business owner's life that they hear the dreaded words, bank reconciliation. Ah, I know. What does it actually mean? Okay, so a bank reconciliation sounds really complicated. It's something your accountant or your bookkeeper might come to you in a panic state and say, like, hey, we can't do our reconciliation this month. So we all know what a bank is, right? We've seen banks our entire life, but reconciliation, that's not a word that we tend to use on a day-to-day basis. So what are we actually talking about? So when someone is doing a bank reconciliation for you, what they're doing is comparing one set of documents with another set of documents. They're comparing the bank statement with all the other records that they've gathered up from you. And so there can be generally two things that can end up happening. You can either have some duplicated transactions, meaning you recorded a transaction more than once. Say you bought item XYZ, but someone typed it in two times. It's in there as a duplicate. Or something was just missed, meaning you bought something, but no one ever recorded it in there. There is nothing more to a bank reconciliation than that. It's just showing that the bank statement you received is different than the listing of all the transactions that have been copied into whatever your accounting source system is. Got it? So really, what you're going to be looking for is two primary situations. You've either doubled up on a transaction, you've missed a transaction, or the third scenario is a scenario where something was entered in a typo type of situation. So maybe you purchased something for $50, but it got input as $5. The other slight nuance under the typo field is a transaction that maybe had to do with a different month, got put into the wrong month. So basically, those are the type of things that your accountant is going to be running around like a crazy person trying to figure out, why isn't it reconciling? What you can tell them to do is take a deep breath. You can take a deep breath for yourself and realize that bank reconciliation is really nothing more than making sure that you've listed everything, you didn't do any typos, and you didn't miss anything. So relax. Remember, a bank reconciliation is not going to be what ultimately drives the profit in your business. A bank reconciliation is really just intended as a tool and a control for yourself and your bookkeeper to make sure that it's their own checks and balances to make sure that they haven't forgotten anything when they were doing their tasks. But it's really not going to be a revenue driver for you or for your business. So what you ultimately want to do is structure your systems and structure your processes in your business to make it as simple as possible to avoid any bank reconciliation issues. What are a few ways that you can do that? Well, number one, limiting the number of various different bank accounts that you have in the first place. So instead of using five different bank accounts for five different purposes, sometimes it can be a lot easier to consolidate into a single spot. Same idea when it comes to how you're recording your various different transactions. If you're using 10 different credit cards from, 10 different contractors that are out and about searching for all kinds of different items to procure on behalf of your business, there's a bigger likelihood that you're going to miss some things, duplicate some things, have a hard time tracking down some different records. So the extent to which you can consolidate and keep the transactions in as much of a single place as you possibly can, the easier you'll make it for yourself to actually be avoiding the combination of two different sets of records that aren't quite matching up. So to avoid most bank reconciliation issues, what you always want to do is go upstream and ask yourself, how can we make this as simple as possible? All right, so you've got this, take a deep breath. Your bank reconciliations, you'll get through it. Every single person makes it through it. There's really only three things that can be wrong. It just needs a little bit of digging. You've got this. I hope that this was helpful for you. Please do take a moment to go check out financelearninglab.com. We have all kinds of great things on the website and would love to be able to help you increase the profits of your business. Take care. We'll see you in the next video.